Hi, if you are facing an error while sending an email by using PHP, or if your PHP script is working on local project but not working on live project, so in this video we will learn how to send an email by using PHP. Here you can see we create one simple demo for you, so you will get idea how to create an or how to send an email by using PHP. Here you need to simply write your to mail ID, CC mail ID and your body. So I simply enter some text. So once you click on send email now, then this demo will work and send an email on your mail ID with CC mark. So let's check we got the mail from this demo or not. And I will also share this whole source code with you, so you will get full source code, so you will download that code, and I also explain how to configure this email ID, and I also explain how to use this email send functionality for your project, right? So we will check we got a mail or not. Here you can see we need to refresh. So here you can see we got a mail from our demo code. So here I will open that mail. So here you can see, hi, this is a test by DVS. Thanks. So this is how this demo is work. And also you will see this CC mark with DVS mail ID. So you can see this mail also receive on that mail ID, right? So here you can see. So you can send both to mail ID and CC mark mail ID. So now how to use or how to configure this mail in your code. So let's see step by step. Here you can see we created some file and include some library to send an email. So once we create index.php, it means this is my index.php. Here you can see I also opened that file. Here you can see we create index.php file, and here we simply design one form like to mail ID, CC mail ID and our body tag, right, with text area. So here we write our some text, and here we create one button like send email now, right? So this is how this form will display. And here you can see when we click on this button send email now, at that time here you can see we call one file like sendmail.php. So you must have to include a form tag, and inside your form tag you must have to use action is equal to sendmail.php. So that file also we have created here. So here you can see sendmail.php. I have already created that file here. So here you can see. So here you can see we get all the details, but before we are getting all detail, we include some library, right? So this is the most important library which is required to send an email. Here you can see we included some library class phpmailer.php and phpmailerautoload.php. That file also we have put it here. So here you can see class phpmailer and some file. That file I also share in my source code, so you will download that whole source code. So in a video description I will share this all the file and everything, right? So you must have to include this file in your project. So you must have to include this all the library. I will share this library with you. Now the most important, here you can see I opened that file here. I already opened that file here. So you must have to configure your host name and your port number and your username and password. This is the most important configuration which is required to send an email. Inside your class phpmailer.php, here you can see we write it down host name and port number and everything. Now here you can see we required this all the detail like host name, port number, but how to get this detail? So for that you must have to log in your hosting provider where you uploaded your website or where you migrated your website on server. So you must have to log in on your server. So here we are using a GoDaddy. So I already log in my GoDaddy cPanel. If you are using another web hosting provider, you must have to go to your cPanel or your hosting provider login. So in that, here you can see we go to email account. You must have to find it out your email accounts, and there is all the detail will available. Or you must have to create your email account first, so that email configuration detail will use in our website. So I already create my mail ID mail@lakshmienterprise.org. That configuration will use while sending an email and receive an email. So here you can see, if you don't know how to create this mail ID, I already created one video for that, how to create an email ID. So you must have to see that video. I also shared this link in my video description, and you can click on this I button, so you will get this, or you can know how to create this mail ID. So if you don't know how to create an email ID, this is simple one. You can create one email ID and everything, right? Now how to configure this, or how to get all the detail, you need to click on this check email, right? And here you will get this mail from your hosting provider, client configuration. This mail you can open, and here you will see this is your username, and this is your host name, and this is your port number, right? So while we are creating your mail ID, at that time you will get all the details. So you must have to use this detail while sending an email by using PHP code. So you must have to use this, or you didn't get or you didn't receive this mail from your hosting provider, don't worry, you can click on this CP button. So there is a one option which is here, you can see configure mail client. So you must have to find it out this configure mail client. So you can go to this option, configure mail client, and there is all detail are available, like host name, port number and everything, right? So here you can see, this is my username, this is my port number, and this is my username, this is my host name, and this is my port number. So this all the detail will configure in this my class PHP mailer. So you go to line number 226 and set this host name. So here you can see I use this host name, I already use this host name, right? And this is my port number 587, so I use that port number. And also you must have to include your username, like this is your username, so I use that username. And here you can use your password. Don't use this password, because once this complete this video, I will change this password, so this is not working for you. So you must have to create your own username and password and your host name, everything. So don't use this password, because I will change this password. So you must have to use your own username and password, right? So don't waste your time to configure this same username and password. You must have to use your own username and password, right? So once you set this configuration in this file class.phpmailer.php, here you can see we get two mail ID, CC mail ID and mail body. We dynamically get this all the detail from index.php. So once we get all the detail, we set dynamical mail body inside here in my body tag. And here you can see we set some subject. And here you can see you can use this from by, suppose you want to display mail at shinerweb.com, or if you want to your own mail ID, then you can change here from mail ID, right? And you can set this from mail from name. Here you can see, while we are receiving an email, here you can see this is my subject, right? Sorry, this is my from name and this is my subject, daily coding solution by Shinerweb. So this is my subject and from mail ID. So you can use your from mail ID like mail at shinerweb.com, which you want to display while sending an email. You must have to set that from mail ID. So, and if you are using HTML while sending an email, so here you can see we are using some HTML code here. So you must have to is email is HTML bracket true, right? And here you can see we dynamically pass two mail ID and CC mail ID. That's why we are passing that add address, it means two mail ID, add CC, it means your CC mark mail ID. Here you can see we also use add BCC. It means if you want to BCC mark, then you can use this BCC mark. Right now we are not using this. And if you want to attach file while sending an email, then you can use this add attachment function. Right now we are not using, but I include that with comment line. So if you want to use, then uncomment this. And this is a body. It means your dynamically generated body will pass inside this MSG HTML. And the most important, mail.send. This function will be used to send an email dynamically by using PHP. So if you have any error at that time, this function will return some error. Or if you have a successfully sent an email by using PHP, then this message will display like message sent. So this is how this email sent functionality will work, or this email sent functionality by using PHP. So I hope you will understand how to send an email by using PHP, or how to configure this code into your project. And if you have any query or any confusion while setting this code into your project, please write it down one simple comment. Or if you successfully configured this code into your project, then also write a comment like a thanks or something like that. So I hope you will like this video, and don't forget to subscribe our channel, because once you subscribe our channel, then you will get this daily code solution. I will share so many video or so many solution in this my YouTube channel. So you must have to subscribe our Shinerweb channel. So I hope you will subscribe our channel, and thanks for watching.